Hi everyone, my name is Tina Amrine and I'm some chick on keto. So I'm not a doctor, I'm not an expert, I'm just some chick on keto. So I wanted to let you know why I decided to start my ketogenic journey. About 7 months ago, I hit a point in my life where I was very unhappy with my weight. And I was also starting to have some problems as far as like with my blood pressure and cholesterol, etc. And so for the first time in my life, I had been put on medication back in 2019. And so now I was in 2020 and I wasn't losing any more weight. I was still gaining weight and I just didn't know what to do with myself. And now we were in the midst of a pandemic. So I decided, I had a friend at work who had started keto, and she was a little older than me, and she was losing weight. You know, she lost like 30 pounds, and I'm like, what is going on here? Like, she's a little older than me, and she's not exercising, she's not doing anything other than changing the way that she's eating. And she still has a life and she's really enjoying the diet. And I said, you know, I think this is something I need to look at, like give it a little bit more attention, because I've heard throughout the years, oh, keto, keto, keto. And I just kind of ignored it because I'm like, I'm not a fad based diet type of person. But she kind of gave it merit for me and I decided to give it a try. So back in June, I attempted to start keto, but I kind of flopped, which is why I kind of wanted to tell you a little bit about me, because a lot of you may start your journey and may experience some of the same things. And I'm just here to tell you, don't beat yourself up about that. If you fall off or you're not able to stick with it, you're gonna have to just get back up and try again. So that's kind of what I did. I kind of looked early June 2020, when I was starting, that those first few weeks were kind of like my trial run weeks of low carb eating rather than keto eating. And it kind of helped prep me along the way. So that's kind of one of the first things I'd tell you, is start slow. So definitely don't jump into it with both feet. Just kind of start weaning yourself off of the carbs, because it's going to be a bit of a shock for your body if you just go immediately into this carb-free living or low-carb living, because your body has to go through a process of learning how to use fat for fuel versus carbs. And so there's some changes that are happening and side effects from those changes. So that kind of leads me into the second thing, which is definitely get your physician's sign off before you start keto, because keto is not for everyone. And again, I'm not a doctor, an expert or scientist, but I'm just here to tell you that if you want to do it safely, you should have your physician's permission to do it, just so that you know that this is something that's okay for you, because keto is definitely not for everybody and it can be hard on certain areas of your body. And there's a right way and a wrong way, I think, to do it. Again, I'm not an expert, but just some chick on keto. So your doctor can kind of help, you know, guide you through some of that process. The third thing I would tell you is that you're going to have to get in there and you're going to have to clean that refrigerator out and you're going to have to clean that cupboard out. And that is hard, because at first you're going to feel like you can't eat anything. But if you don't take care of the problem that's already there inside the cupboard, then you're just kind of setting yourself up for disaster. So what I'm going to say is you're going to have to clean your cupboards out, clean your fridge out, and just start maybe shopping for some keto-friendly options to stock up in, so that as you do fade out of the carbs and you fade into the high-fat diet, you're going to have things to reach for when you start to get the cravings, because the cravings are going to come. So kind of coming back to myself, you know, I am almost 50. I'm turning 50 this year in July 2021. And when I started this journey in June of 2020, June 25th of 2020 is when I officially started keto. And I was amazed that I was able to drop 30 pounds without exercising. For me, that was life-changing and amazing because for the past 20 plus years, ever since I started having kids, I was not able to drop weight. It just felt like I just looked at food and I gained weight. And it didn't matter how much I exercised, I would have to kill myself at the gym in order to just lose a few pounds. And I was just tired of it. I was never really a huge eater as far as quantity and food size, but what I didn't realize is how much carbs were affecting my body. And, you know, I think everybody has a different relationship with that, and everybody has a different point in the journey where they are with that, and that's okay. Your journey may not look like mine. Mine may not look like anybody else's, but that's okay. This is your journey, and you may lose 50 pounds in 6 months. You know, you may lose 10 pounds in 6 months, but either way, it's okay as long as the numbers are going down and you're getting healthier in the process. So I would just encourage you again to do the 1-2-3s, which is, you know, start slow, get your doctor's buy off, and clean out the pantry and the fridge of all the junk that's out there so you're not tempted and you're kind of stocked up with some of the things that you can eat. And I will tell you, going from eating carbs, which is typically low calorie, but low calorie and low fat, to going to a high fat diet, which is high fat and sometimes high calorie, is really kind of strange because it is going to be messing with your head. Because all my life I've been told, oh, you know, eat a little salad with some brown rice and, you know, some chicken, some lean chicken, and that's going to be good. And I didn't realize, well, the salad dressing that I'm spreading on there is probably not the right choice that I'm making, or the brown rice that I was dumping in there was not the right choice for me, or the corn or whatever, croutons, whatever is in there was not good for me. But I'm learning, and I'm hoping that you're going to come along on the journey and learn with me, and I'm excited to do this together. So I'm going to ask if you'd be kind enough to hit the subscribe button, and if you'd also hit the like button for me, and also the notification bell so you know when we post new content. I also have an Instagram page where you can follow me. It's called Some Chick on Keto. So again, my name is Tina Amrine. Thank you so much for your time. It means a lot to me, and your time is very important to me. And just remember, I'm not a doctor. I'm not an expert. I'm just some chick on keto. So please join me for the next video. Thanks. Bye.